Hello students, in last video we have seen identity theft, credit card frauds, password sniffing, computer network intrusions, how Usenet used for committing cyber crimes. Up to this we have seen some of cyber crimes, how they were, how cyber criminals will commit those crimes. Next we will see the cyber crime perspectives. What is perspective? Perspective means the way we see something. Okay, here we are seeing a cyber crime. So first we will see the legal perspective of a cyber crime. Legal perspective means what? According to laws, what is a cyber crime? According to Criminal Justice Resource Manual, which is defined in 1979, computer crime is illegal activity for which knowledge of computer's technology is essential for successful prosecution. It means, suppose one person committed illegal activity, for that computer technology knowledge is required to carry out the successful investigation or legal proceedings against that person for his criminal activity. International legal aspects of computer crimes were studied in 1983. According to that study, computer crime was defined as illegal activity for which knowledge of computer technology is essential to carry out the cyber crime. Here, perpetration is means to carrying out. Cyber crime is outcome of globalization. What is globalization? Globalization means speed up of movements and exchanges of goods, services, capitals, technologies all over the world. It may be exchange between two nations also, countries also. Okay, globalization increasing interaction between different regions, nations and populations around the world. Globalized information systems, for example databases, giving area to build the large number of offenses in a national boundaries. Okay, for this problem they have given two solutions. The first one is divide the information systems into segments limited to state boundaries. Okay, we have to limit those information systems within state only. The second one is, either we need to include any one of the legal systems given by the law into an integrated entity. It means in a world, we need to include any of the legal systems by destroying these state boundaries. The next is cybercrime in Indian perspective. India has fourth highest number of internet users in the world, around 45 million users. 37% of internet access happens from cyber cafes and 57% of users are between ages 18 to 35. There is 50% rise in cybercrime in the year 2007 as compared to 2006, which is recorded in Information Technology Act. The majority of cyber criminals are under age 30 years. The 46% of cases are related to cyber pornography and hacking. So, the Indian government is doing its best to control all these cyber crimes. Policies are trained for 6 weeks in computer hardware, software, data communication network, network protocols and network security to handle these kind of cyber crimes. Next is the cyber crime and Indian ITA 2000. It has given some laws, rules and regulations to handle the cyber crimes. The first one is cyber crime and Indian ITA 2000. Here, in India, ITA 2000 made law in a January 30, 1997. This was the first law related to e-commerce at international level to regulate the e-commerce. The next is hacking and Indian laws. Cybercrime is punishable under two categories, the ITA 2000 and IPC. IPC means Indian Penal Code. Total 207 cases of cyber crime were registered under ITA Act in 2007 compared to 142 cases are registered in 2006. Under IPC, 339 cases are recorded in 2007 compared to 311 cases in 2006. The offense cases are increasing yearly. So, some provisions are given under ITA 2000. In this table, they have given section number, chapter of the act and title, crime and punishment for that crime. The first section is section 43. What crime? Under this section, they have given one crime, that is damage to computer system. Punishment for that is compensation for ₹1 crore. They have to pay ₹1 crore. Section 66, here hacking, they have to pay fine ₹2 lakh and imprisonment for 3 years. Section 67, this is for publication of offense material in an electronic form, they have to pay fine for 1 lakh, imprisonment of 5 years and double conviction on second offense. If they done second time, they have to pay double amount of this. Section 68, here they have to follow the some rules of controller. If they go against the controller, they have to pay fine for 2 lakhs and imprisonment of 3 years. Under section 70, the crime is attempting or securing access to computer of another person without his or her knowledge. For this, punishment is imprisonment up to 10 years. Section 72, the crime is attempting or securing access to computer for breaking confidentiality of information of the computer. For this, they have to pay fine for 1 lakh and imprisonment of 2 years. Section 73. Publishing false digital signature falls in a certain particulars. For this, they have to pay fine up to 1 lakh or a imprisonment up to 2 years. Or they have to take punishment both. Section 74, publication of digital signatures for fraudulent. They have to pay fine up to ₹1 lakh and imprisonment. The next is global perspective on cyber crimes. Here it is important to understand the concept of extended enterprise. Enterprise is nothing but organization or a business or a company. Here, extended enterprise means company or a business is not made up of just its employees, its board members and executives. It also includes its business partners, its suppliers, its customers, okay? Some outsourcing, strategic analysis and all. The extended enterprises are successful only if all the component groups and individuals must have information they need in order to do the business effectively. They have to work together. Then only the extended enterprise become successful. An extended enterprise is a loosely coupled, self-organizing network of a firm or a company that combine their economic output to provide products and services offering those to markets. Okay, the economic or annual income depends on both outside companies or suppliers, business partners also, or inside employees, executives also. It depends on both. International cooperation is needed at the level of governments, industry, consumer business and technical groups to achieve global cyber security. The next is, they have given two terms and difference between them. It is very important to know about computer crime and computer fraud and what is the difference. Computer fraud, any defalcation or embezzlement accomplished by tampering with the computer programs, data files, operations, equipment or media, and resulting in losses sustained by the organization whose computer system was manipulated. Here, defalcation or embezzlement means legal act. They will carry out this activity legally. Here, cyber criminals get access to the computer programs, data files, operations, equipments legally, and results in continuation of losses in an organization whose computer system was manipulated. The next is computer crime. It is an act performed by knowledgeable computer user, sometimes referred to as a hacker, that illegally browses or steals a company's or an individual's private information. Next, we will see what is the difference between these two. Computer crime differs from computer fraud in two major ways. Employees as a part of their normal duties have access to the computers are deemed to have authorized access and thus do not come under the law against the access. Okay, in an organization, every employees need to do their normal duties. They have to access the computers authorized legally only, okay? But they will do some illegal activities, okay? That is not considered against the law. The second one is manipulation, that is alteration or destruction of data is independent of fraudulent or other schemes, okay? In a same company, if employee belongs to that company, this alteration or destruction of data is independent of fraudulent. Okay, they will not came to know he is doing some alteration or destroying a data. Thank you.